rich. We want tax rich. But the reality is, this legislation, if you want to kill job creation or the incentive to create jobs, anything else would go far. We keep that, our board makes a decision not to get into the weeds when it comes to that issue in terms of what the income. Those things are going to work out. Our opposition and concern about the health care, what's being proposed is the amount of tax on businesses. And that's really concerning. If you look at what's happened this year, that margins tax that was applied to small businesses, knock on wood, that got to be up from $300,000 to $1 million. And in our community, we got the local government, our city government, talking about assignment. Sole proprietors are not important, not important. Most small businesses have sole proprietorship, and so they have what they pay is directly, their taxes are directly out of what they make. So you're looking at 8% surtax on business. Once you've taken some of your deductions, depending on what they will allow in terms of calculating this surtax, when you see what your mom and dad adjust gross adjusted income, what would be taxed off of it? Okay? So you have what businesses would have to pay, then you have what individuals have to
pay. When you look at it, you actually live a better quality of life.
But, I'm sure some of you have gone through situations where you've lost health insurance or were transferred in between jobs and didn't have. I mean, it's a frightening proposition. When something happens, it's, people go bankrupt. You look at some of the bankruptcy filings.
They're
all related to something's happened in that family's life that caused them to have to go to lose money.
I have a brother right now that
wants
to retire. He's 62.
A lot of this debate's been going on for years, and I think you're going to continue through it. And I go back to Churchill's quote.